I guess we should take the uncertainty
Yeah.
that we actually started
Yeah,
out
I know
with.
a lot of guys are excited to take a closer look at that one.
Yeah.
This, ladies and gentlemen, is an original uncertainty model. This is the gold.
This is the goal, yeah.
Yeah.
Loads of stories about this kit. For starters, for me, this was in many years one of my holy grails. I really wanted to get a hand on one of these monogram kits.
Yeah.
And the story about the car is that, oh, I can see now the seat, one of the seats has loose. I had to take out that, had to
No,
fix that
okay.
later. I just realized that's funny.
Yeah, that's what
Here's one of the
happens.
seats.
Yeah.
Okay, it's sitting here.
Oh, it just need a little glue
Yeah,
and
that's a quick fix.
yeah.
Yeah, the original car was built in the 60s. I think it was in 65. It was a guy called Steve Scott. He's still around. That built it, or I don't know if he got someone to build it for him, but he was the owner. And he attended a lot of shows at that time in the States and won a lot of trophies. And the trophy over here is actually a model of one of the trophies that he won. And
Ah,
one
okay.
funny thing is, when I purchased the kit, the only thing that was not as it should be in the kit was one of the what's this called? One of the figures that are
Yeah.
should sit over here,
Okay.
but it's lying down there. I just glue it. It's dropped off, so I just glue it
Yeah.
on the pedestal. But
Yeah.
that's a minor thing. But he built it back then, and I had a lot of success displaying it, and it's quite radical,
Yeah.
especially at that time. And as it is at many shows today, it also was at that time, is that you actually had to be able to start the engine and drive the car by
Yeah.
its own machine into the exhibition hall.
Yeah.
So this car in the real world is actually drivable.
Yeah.
And according to Steve Scott, that I do ride with once in a while, the car still exists, but he don't have it anymore. But he do know its whereabouts, where it is. But what's the plan with it, I really don't know.
No, okay.
Last year, or was it in 2019? I'm not sure. A Australian guy made a copy of it,
Okay,
and
yeah.
he actually showed it in the States and had a lot of success with it over there. And to get it licensed and registered in Australia, it's a right-hand drive. That's quite
Yeah.
funny,
Yeah,
but
okay.
otherwise it has the same Buick nail head
Yeah.
engine, and it just looks like a real car.
Yeah.
I have some, there's some things with my build that are not quite as the original car, and
Okay.
one of the thing is that I used a copper tone
Yeah.
On the paint, and in the real world it's more like candy red, but still with
Ah,
some copper
okay.
in it.
But it's a beautiful color.
I really like that
Yeah,
color,
yeah.
yeah. And then the right car don't have white walls on
Ah.
the rear tires.
Yeah, okay.
And another thing, small detail, is that I made the rear window frame, I made it out of bare metal foil, but the real car don't have a chrome around the window
Ah,
at the
okay.
rear. So
Yeah,
that's,
but it looks good, so
yeah, it's.
yeah. And it's quite funny with that one, because when it comes down to it, compared to a lot of other show rods from the 60s,
yes,
there's not so much done to that car, actually.
No. It's very, very simple.
Yeah, it's just a tilted
really,
cap, actually.
Really simple
yeah.
build. Yeah, actually. But I think it's because of... It has some what's called charm
yeah.
to it. Its appearance is really lovable somehow. I have a story with this kit. As I mentioned, I wanted it so badly, and had the wish to buy one for many years, and I was looking through eBay once in a while. And one of the reasons is that it has never been reissued. All of a sudden it just stopped making them, and the original molds, the tools, I've heard that it doesn't exist any longer.
No,
so
okay.
it's a very rare kit.
Yeah. Yeah.
But at one time on eBay, I found a mint condition kit, and it was really expensive. I don't recall the price, but I just had to have it. Mm. And I won the auction, and I was told that it was shipped just right after I paid it through PayPal.
Yeah.
But I never received it.
Oh.
And I couldn't get hold on the seller. And at that time, you couldn't get a cash refund through PayPal as you can today. So it was like gone. And I was very depressed over it.
Yeah, that's bad luck.
Yeah. So I took a long walk at the beach, think about my life in general. And then I said, I just have to find another one.
Yeah.
And then I found this one.
Yeah.
And this time it was insured to over the ceilings to get it in the proper way in the mail and so on. And I actually, the same day when I received it and opened the box, I started building it.
So you never did receive the first one?
Nope.
Or
never.
Get any refund or anything? Nope.
Nothing. So I paid for this two times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's unfortunately how it goes sometimes.
Yeah, yeah. It is.
It's all of the base and all of the stuff in the kit, actually.
It is. Even the wire is in the kit.
Yeah, yeah.
And there's enough wire to do two turns.
Yeah.
So everything that you see are in the kit.
Yeah.
I, at one point in Sweden, there was another guy that had built it. Original kit, and he came closer to the right color of the paint, more candy red, and he had made another display because his kit was not complete, so he didn't have the display, so he had made another display to his kit, and he didn't have the trophy either that comes with it.
Okay.
Yeah.
It looks great.
Yeah, thank you.
I can understand it's a very popular kit.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. You know, I have to admit that I have never had the biggest feelings for the uncertainty, but this is the first time I actually see it live.
Mm-hmm.
And it actually grows on me, I must say.
I can fully understand you because I have heard it before.
Yeah.
That especially people that I'm also very interested and into show rods that you are.
Yeah.
And I love show rods in all shapes. And unfortunately, I didn't bring any other show rods with me today.
We take that next time.
Yeah. But and I really like radical show rods. And this is not in any way radical.
But I
think it has something to it.
It has that kind of cartoonish charm.
Yeah.
Somehow.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's small and cute.
Yeah, it is. It is. But yeah. I think it's not that funny to drive.
No, probably not.
As most of the show roads.
I saw a clip where they drive the Red Baron, actually.
Yeah, I saw that you posted.
Yeah. It's not made for long trips. Let's just say like that.
Yeah. Yeah. But I have some homework with this seat.
You can put it together a little bit now again.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, this is Heller Mercedes 300 SL Gunwing. This build started out with the wheels, actually.
Ah, okay.
The wheels started the project.
Yeah.
And you know where the wheels are from, because I've already forgotten it.
It's Ari wheels.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There you have it.
Or Otaki wheels, they are called also. Yeah.
Yes.
Very and rare and very, very nice.
Yeah, very nice wheels.
Yeah.
And it was just one day I was, because those wheels are in 1:24 scale.
Yeah.
Which is very rare, actually, with US kits. At one day I took out the rims and tires and wanted to find something odd to make a Pro Street look alike car, and that could have been any American model, but somehow I found out that this body on the Mercedes just sat perfect with the wheels.
Yeah, it does.
So I actually built this kit out of the box and painted it in a color that you don't normally see those skull wings in. You see them in silver, of course, and in red, and what's black, I've seen them.
Yeah, and off-white, I think.
Yeah,
also.
That's right. Yeah, racing white, something. Yeah. Yeah. So this is a box stock kit that just has been dropped and then added those rims.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Plain and simple. So all the trim is original. There's nothing.
All the trim is original. Yeah. There's a lot of trim.
Yeah.
There's a lot of bare metal foil around the windows and so on. So I can see now this is actually, I remember this is actually fully painted with Motip. Rattle can paint.
Yeah, yeah.
And I can see now that there's something happening with the paint at the roof. It's matte out at one side. I don't know why, but it is.
Okay.
It has its own life.
I never had any problems in that direction with the Motip paint, but things can happen.
So quite simple and
a beautiful car.
Yeah, it's like a jewelry. Really. I can't say that word in English, but
it's probably not a car you would see in 1:1.
No, nope,
anyway.
I don't think so. But because those cars in real world, they are so expensive that it costs many, 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 many.
But I can tell you, if I ever get to become a billionaire, that Mercedes has always been one of my dream cars.
Yeah, me too.
And I never figured it stuck. So nope. If I ever became a billionaire, you would see one customized.
And
I know probably a lot of people want to kill me for just saying that. But
yeah.
That's the way
purchase out there would kill you, that's for sure. Yeah, and they do have the money to kill you for.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, but it's a beautiful model. It looks really great, especially with the color. I think the color and then the red interior, it looks killer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was also when I was near finishing it, I was, because it was not planned to be as it is, but when it was near completion, I was like, sometimes you just get stunned on the appearance of when it's done and it's sitting on its wheels and so on. This is just, out of this world, I think.
Yeah, it's great. Mm-hmm. I know that feeling sometimes. You can just sit and look at the model you're about to finish, you know, and just sit and look at it for an hour.
Yeah.
It looks so great.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's a nice feeling.
And this build can still do it.
Yeah. I understand. Mm-hmm.
This is an NPC reissued kit of Dino Don Johnson's Mercury Cyclone. I think it's the 67 year model, and it's actually built out of the box. And I was planning from the very beginning building this kit that I wanted it to look just like the real car in the real world.
Yeah.
And when I was researching on Dino Don Johnson and his different drag racing cars, I get more and more interested in the guy and more interested in his cars. So I have actually since then purchased some other kits. Also the Eliminator 1 that came before this, and I don't recall the name, but another Mercury Cyclone from Moebius. Those are going to be built in the future as well. Maybe you have seen it today that red is a color that are going through many of my models.
Yes, I was thinking about that color.
Yeah, and that's for me personally a bit funny because my favorite color is actually blue.
Okay.
Any shape and kind of blue is my favorite color.
Yeah.
But I do build a lot of red cars.
Yeah.
This has a candy effect to it. To get a candy effect, I always use what's it called? Clear paints.
Yeah.
Like this is a red clear over a gold bottom. You can also use silver bottom.
Yeah.
To get the candy effect.
Yeah. Is it that also for the rear lights? The clear red?
No, this is for this I used Tamiya products.
Ah, okay. Yeah.
I use normally only use Tamiya nowadays.
Yeah, okay.
And that's just because I like to work with it and I know how it's handling.
Yeah.
But somehow you can't get any colors in Tamiya, so if I can't find the right color, I always go to Motip and find it there instead.
Yeah.
Because Motip, I also know how it works.
Yeah.
And then if you just want to make some silk matte black or something, I just buy the cheapest I can find in the stores.
Yeah, that will do the job.
Yeah, that will do the job just nicely.
Yeah. But do you also use the Tamiya's clear coat then on top?
No. That's a really good thing that you're asking, because when I do make a model, oh, it's a really good thing that you're asking, because this is very important. Using Tamiya spray cans, I learned some years ago that they are not good on decals. They eat decals. They are not. I would say maybe there's some decals out there that can withstand Tamiya's clear coat.
Mm.
I don't know, but most of the decals that I'm working with cannot withstand them.
Yeah,
so
that's
instead,
not good.
I talked with our good late friend Jakob Stoppel that passed away recently.
Yeah, sadly, yeah.
He told me that he have heard about that problem, and he said that I should maybe try out Mr. Hobby's clear coat instead. And I took home one bottle of Mr. Hobby clear coat.
Is that spray can also?
That's also spray can, and that's in the same size as Tamir's bottles.
Yeah. Okay.
I took it home and had a success right away with it. And since then, I haven't used anything else.
No, than of course. That. Yeah.
So.
That's great.
Yeah.
Good to know.
Yeah, it's really good to know.
Yeah.
When you, because if you want to go through the Tamiya range of colors and just want to paint out there, and then you gone to the clear coat and
and
it seems like it eating up the decals. Well, a good model is ruined.
But that must be tough, you know. You did put a really nice coat of color and you put the decals and then
just
gone.
Ruined.
Terrible.
But then again, if I'm doing a model and there's no decals on it, I usually use Tamiya clear coat because Mr. Hobby is a little bit more expensive than Tamiya, and Tamiya is expensive enough as it is. So it's just like that.
But never mind, if there's no decals anyway, then of course
you can, because the quality of the clear coat is okay. But at this model, I only added some details to the engine, like spark plugs and wires, spark plug wires as well. So that's about it. And then I'm not so proud of it, but I have to show it.
Okay.
Because sometimes
we like honesty.
I'm not sure if you can see it, but on the roof.
Yeah. There's a little black spot.
There was a black spot, and that was when I was clear coating it. It was still in the boot, and my paint boot is not totally dust free. And somehow, you know, a big dust, what's it called?
Spiggle.
Came down on the clear coat.
Oh, yeah.
And I was sitting at it, and it's quite funny, because sometimes when I have seen, when I've clear coating models, I could see when I'm clear coating that there were some dust, but when it's dry out, it's not there. So sometimes I just like, well, I have to see when it's dry out.
Yeah.
But at this point, I just knew that this is not going to be good.
Yeah.
So I did a very bad thing. I was trying to remove it while the paint still was wet.
Yeah.
So this what was happening.
Yeah.
Then at one point, I was planning to take, I believe I have a helmet in there somewhere. I'm not sure. Mm. But the first plan was to that the whole funny car body should be down.
Yeah.
In the closed position, and then I would just place a helmet on the ceiling.
Yeah.
But when I finished the car, I said, well, it looks quite cool when it's open position. So I placed at open position, and of course then you can't have a helmet sitting up there, but because you would never see that in real world.
No, that's
so
true.
It's just, you know, like it is.
You know.
Yeah.
Sometimes cars in the real world, they also have a little spot.
Yeah, especially
there, you know.
Dragsters.
yeah, exactly. So
because they get burnt out, and because there's a lot of things happening when you go down the quarter mile.
Yeah, that's because of the pistons he shot out last week.
Yeah.
He forgot to clean the roof.
That's a good story. I take that right away.
Yeah.
But this was funny, and of course, as I mentioned before, I got quite interested in Don Johnson and his cars, and he raced a lot of cars, and he at one point he also hired drivers to race his car, so he only did the construction.
Yeah, okay.
And there's actually a lot of kits out there with Don Johnson's race cars. So
are they mostly altered wheelbase?
No. Also, one of the The Eliminator 1,
yeah,
that's also just called Eliminator, is actually quite stock.
Okay.
And it's not with a flip body.
Okay.
Yeah. And it's also on a quite stocky frame as well.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah.
Because I have to admit that the altered wheelbase,
mm-hmm,
has never really been my cup of tea, you
know.
No. But it looks funny, but I have to admit I like the cars with the normal wheelbase better.
Yeah.
You know, but never mind. There was a lot of altered wheelbase out there.
Yeah.
So, and it's not to take anything away from your model, because it looks amazing.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So I was just wondering if it was mostly altered wheelbase he drove.
No.
But apparently not. Both.
No. Yeah. He came through different classes through his career. And I actually said something wrong here, because the Eliminator 1, that is just called Eliminator, which is a Cougar, is actually also on a special built frame. And it does have a tilted body. It is the Comets clone that I also have as a kit that are quite stockish. So I just mix something up here.
Yeah, yeah. So, it's okay. Yeah.
Sometimes the brain don't listen to what the mouth says and opposite.
Yeah, that's the way it is. Also, with all the kits we have, we cannot remember every kit.
And I'm very, very bad at names, not only... names on persons, but also on cars.
Yes. So that was the models you brought today.
That was models I brought today.
It was a great sight, I must say.
Yeah,
great
models. And it's really funny to sit and talk about them, because all of a sudden you just the most funny thing is all the funny stories that you all of a sudden get a hold on in your head.
Yeah, when you sit and talk about the models, you often suddenly remember something that you didn't think about, you know, and suddenly all of the stories just come out.
Yeah.
And that's one of the best things about going to exhibitions like we talked about before and meeting your fellow modelers.
Yeah, yeah.
All the stories, you know.
Yeah.
So
for me building models, mostly cast nowadays, it's like therapy for me.
Yeah, exactly.
Because when you're sitting there, when you're going to the table and sitting down and start a building, it's just like therapy. And you, I will not say that you forget about what's happening in the world outside, but if you have something to think about, a problem or something, you all of a sudden forget about it, and it's just like therapy for me.
Yeah,
and have always been, and that's one of many reasons why I really love this hobby.
Yeah,
and I just when we go to exhibitions and I see youngsters and kids that are building kits, which is very rare these days.
Yeah.
I can really feel in my heart that I get very happy, and I really want to support them in any way, because there's not many out there.
No, that's true.
Teenagers and
that's true. But I think it's coming, because I think if you look at the Facebook pages and the groups all around on the internet, that, you can see more and more also young people that's starting to build. And also, I heard a lot of guys say that some of the builds they bring out now is aimed at beginning modelers, you know.
Okay,
For instance, Atlantis just brought out the two Snoopy airplane kits.
Ah, okay,
Stuff like that, you know, with very easy to build, often snap-type kits and
Which is very important
when you
start out.
Yeah, exactly. You cannot start with some complicated glue model.
No.
So,
because that would just stop the interest right away, because it's too complicated, too difficult.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So let's hope that we see more junior modelers.
Yeah. Definitely. That would be so. Nice.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Erik, I want to say thank you very much for coming and showing your models here.
I'm so happy that you wanted me here.
You're always welcome.
Yeah.
And I already, my mind is already set on making a some kind of show rod special. At
yeah, that
point,
would
you know?
Be nice.
Yeah.
That would be a really good idea.
Yeah.
Because not only you can display a lot of show rods, but I also have something sitting on the shelf at home.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And maybe I could build something special for the special.
We can
because
do that.
Because it's actually been quite some time since I last built a show rod. So
Yeah. But I'm working on two also right
all
now.
Right.
One of them is very rare, so I want to finish those also first.
Okay.
But let's do that. We make a show rod special
it's all,
later.
Always good to have plans.
Yes, exactly.
To the future.
So. Okay, so thank you for watching. And
thank you for having me.
Yeah, you're always welcome. And I thank you guys for watching the video, and I hope you will like and share. And remember, as I always say, models are made to be built, so build them.
That's right.
Yeah. See you in the next episode. Bye-bye.
Bye.